Hello and welcome to Chanakya IAS Academy. I'm Priya Kumari and today's topic for discussion is India's first driverless metro train. Subject of discussion is why this topic is in news, then key details, terms to ponder upon or technicalities of driverless metro train and significance of driverless metro train. So we will see one by one. Now recently, PM Modi flagged off India's first ever driverless train for Delhi Metro's Magenta Line. Along with PM Modi, Delhi CM that is Arvind Kejriwal also attended the virtual event. So because of this, what are the key details of this driverless metro train? So we will see that the first driverless train will roll out on the 38-kilometer line or magenta line of the Delhi Metro, which has 390-kilometer long network spread across the national capital and adjoining cities such as Noida, Gurugram, Faridabad, Ghaziabad and Bahadurgarh. PM Modi also launched the fully operational National Common Mobility Card services on the airport express line. The DMRC also announced that they are preparing to introduce similar service on their 57-kilometer pink line by mid of 2021. New driverless train will have 6 coaches and is equipped with several advanced features. Now, initially, these trains will have drivers deputed for operating, but they would be gradually withdrawn to move to unattended train operation. The driverless train technology has set standards for automation called grades of automation. So here you should notice three terms, that is National Common Mobility Card, then you have unattended train operation and grades of automation. These three terms are actually important. So technicalities, if we will see, then this automatic train operation is an operational safety enhancement device. It is used to help automate the operation of trains. So the degree of the automation is indicated by grade of automation up to level 4. So from level 1 to level 4. So in first phase, the trains will be run by one driver. In second and third phase, the driver's role is further reduced. What they do? They only operate doors and take over in emergency cases. So even the starting and halting of train is automated in level 2 and level 3. Now in level 4 phase, the trains will be operational in complete automated mode. Now this automatic train operation is primarily used on automated guideway transit and rapid transit systems where it is easier to ensure the safety of humans. On most systems, there is a driver present to mitigate risk associated with failures or emergencies. Now we will see this One Nation, One Mobility Card. Like initially I told you that along with driverless metro card, PM Modi also launched National Common Mobility Card. Now this idea of this card was floated by Nandan Nilekani Committee. This was set up by the RBI. Now, what is this National Common Mobility Card? This is an automatic fare collection system. What this will do? This will turn smartphones into an interoperable transport card that commuters or passengers can use eventually to pay for metro, bus, and suburban railway services. This will also allow passengers with RuPay debit card issued in the last 18 months by 23 banks, which includes SBI, UCO, Canara Bank, Punjab National Bank, etc., to be swiped for metro travel. Now, this card can be used at all transit locations, making all new metro and transit payment interoperable via one card. See, these things are important. All transit locations, all new metro, okay, only via one card. Then this will use your smartphone. Then this is automatic. See, these are the key terms which you should know. Now, this will allow entry and exit from metro stations with the help of a smartphone known as automatic fare collection system. See, this is again an important term, automatic fare collection system. So to make automatic fare collection system compliant, indigenous gates for metro stations, the government has engaged who? Bharat Electronics Limited. So remember this name, Bharat Electronics Limited. Eventually, all metro stations will be fitted with AFC gates. Now, what is the significance? The significance is, because of this driverless metro train, DMRC has entered the elite league of 7% of world's metro networks. The first driverless train, as it will be fully automated, it will eliminate the possibility of human error. So this is complete or fully automatic without any person or human. So India's urban mass rapid transit will mark a milestone because of this achievement. For this driverless metro, this project, no separate budget has been allocated or was allocated for driverless trains. It was actually already part of phase 3 of metro expansion. So already this rupees 40,000 crore was allocated for phase 3. Under this only, this driverless metro has been launched. So let me tell you here that the world's first fully automated driverless railway opened in Japan's Kobe in 1981. And you can see that in India, it happened in 2020. So that's all for today. We will see you in next topic. Thank you and have a nice day.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. And press the bell icon to never miss an update.